Who giveth this woman to be married to this man? Give a little parting kiss. Put your arm in his and come forward and hold this way just a little bit. Bill and Heller, marriage is a lawful estate into which you're both now entering, and in which you will find a deeper meaning of faith and love. By reading in the Bible, we notice that when God had created man and placed him upon the earth, he saw that it wasn't good for man to live out his life alone. And so from man's side, he brought forth woman, and thus established their need for each other, signifying that they again should be united through the bonds of holy matrimony, again becoming one flesh, being joined in all the hopes, the aims, and sins of this life. We also read that when Jesus Christ was upon the earth, nearly 2,000 years ago, that he honored and sanctioned marriage by his presence at the wedding at Cana of Galilee. And the Apostle Paul declared that marriage is honorable. Therefore, if you, Phil and Helen, have chosen each other as partners in this holy estate, and know of no just cause why you should not be so united, will you now join your right hands together? Phil, in taking this woman you hold by the right hand to be your lawful wedded wife in the presence of God, you must promise to love her and to honor and cherish her in this relation, and leaving all others, cleave only unto her, and be to her in all things a true and faithful husband, so long as you both shall live. Do you so promise?
I do.
Heller, in taking this man who holds you by the right hand to be your lawful wedded husband, you also must promise to love him, and to honor and cherish him in this relation, and leaving all others, cleave only unto him, and be to him in all things a true and faithful wife, so long as you both shall live. Do you so promise?
I do.
And you're given each to the other for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, until death shall separate you. Now see the rings, please. The rings that you're exchanging are symbolic of the promises you both just made. For the rings are made of a material that doesn't tarnish, signifying that your love for each other shall always be true and faithful and shall never become tarnished. Also, the ring being made in a circle having no end, again signifies there shall be no end to your love for each other. You can hand your flower to your best man made of honor. He says it's anything he needs to be. Place the ring upon her finger now. Holding a ring on her finger and looking at each other. Repeat these words to your bride. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
With loyal love.
With loyal love.
I thee endow.
I thee endow.
And all my worldly goods.
And all my worldly goods.
With thee I share.
With thee I share.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And the Son.
And the Holy Ghost.
And the Holy Ghost.
Tell her place this ring upon his finger. Holding a ring, repeat these words to your groom. With this ring,
with this ring,
I thee wed.
With loyal love,
I thee endow.
And all my worldly goods,
with thee I share.
With thee I share.
In the name of the Father,
and the Son,
and the Holy Ghost. Now, holding all four hands together between you, let us bow our heads in prayer and ask God's blessing to be upon your marriage. Heavenly Father, we do ask a special blessing to be upon Phil and Heller as they go from this chapel as man and wife. And may the love that brought them to this very wonderful hour always remain just as beautiful and precious to them as it is this moment. And may there be deeply implanted in their hearts the desire to make each other's life as full and happy and complete as it can be upon this earth. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ rest upon them, blessing their lives and beautifying their home. In Christ's name we pray, amen. Now while you're holding hands and just looking at each other for a while longer, listen to these very special words about love. For the commitment that you just made was born out of your love for each other, and out of your sincere desire to spend the rest of your life together as husband and wife. Within that commitment, you'll also find the reality of being each other's best friend, companion, sweetheart, and lover. Always caring more about each other's happiness than you do your own, for that's what love is. And that's what makes marriage beautiful. And having been a minister for 43 years and been married myself for 42 of those years to the same lovely woman, I have this little word of advice to pass on to each couple that stands before me. The feeling that you had for each other when you fell in love, and that feeling grew until you finally proposed to her and she accepted the proposal. That feeling was deep in your heart, and it went something like this. I love you so much that I want to spend the rest of my life with you. I want us to spend every day together, and I want us to be together each night. I want to be together with you in all the times of happiness that come our way as we live together as husband and wife and build our home and our future. I want us to be together when happiness tries to elude us, because I know that our love will just mature that much more and will remain happy all the days of our lives. And truly, Phil and Heller, the three words that you said to each other when you fell in love, and you've been saying that ever since, if you'll continue to say those three words for the rest of your lives, your marriage will last just that long for the rest of your lives. And those three words are, I love you. Always communicate those words to each other every day. And seeing as you have vowed your love each to the other in the presence of God, by the authority vested in me by the state of Nevada, I do now pronounce you husband and wife. When God joins together, let no one ever put asunder, and you may bring his hands, embrace, and kiss your bride. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You're welcome, and best wishes.
Thank you.